Do you have memories you wish you could hold on to forever? Do you feel like sometimes they're getting less vibrant? That's probably because our working memory starts to decline as soon as our late 20s. Oh my God, it's all downhill from here, isn't it? But new neuroscience research says that electrical stimulation could drastically improve our memory performance. Would you do it? In case you hadn't noticed, your brain is a complicated place. It has lots of different kinds of memory, and working memory is the kind in charge of remembering information that's no longer directly in front of you. This can be the temporary preservation of something that just happened, or the retrieval of something from your long-term memory. It's the part of your cognition that's essential for things like processing and understanding language, logical and spatial reasoning, planning, and of course, remembering where you last saw your car keys. Our commonly accepted model for how working memory works is that it's the result of coordination between different kinds of brainwaves. Brainwaves are the pulses of electrical activity in your neurons, and those pulses can occur at different frequencies, resulting in different kinds of brainwaves. Gamma waves have a high frequency and are associated with the storage and processing of sensory information, while theta waves have a longer frequency and are associated with lots of different brain states, from an engaged brain that's actively monitoring something to a brain during REM sleep. And when your working memory is activated, say you're pulling a memory from long-term storage because you're looking back on a detail from your wedding day, those two types of waves couple and synchronize to build you a sense memory picture of the thing you're trying to remember. They work in tandem to weave your memories together. As we get older, our brains change. We may lose gray matter volume, our circulation can get worse, so our brains may get less blood and oxygen. There are lots of possible structural neurobiological changes. Another change associated with aging is a decrease in synchronization between regions of the brain. Whereas before you may have been able to recall with perfect clarity the look on your spouse's face as you said, "I do," as we get older, researchers start to see these brainwaves pulse out of sync. The coupling and synchronization of the brainwaves gets offbeat, and details like that may fade away. And of course, working memory is important for much more than reminiscing. It's required for daily life function, like remembering where you keep the knives and forks, or retaining new information from a doctor's appointment. So once we start to lose working memory, like with age-related dementia, we see a potential decrease in quality of life and independence. So it makes sense that we'd want to improve that, right? Well, now you can for the low, low price of shocking your brain with electricity. It's actually not as scary as it sounds. This particular study used a non-invasive electrical stimulation method called transcranial alternating current stimulation to, for lack of a better word, zap the prefrontal and temporal regions of the brain simultaneously. This jumpstarts the offbeat gamma and theta waves back into sync. The result? Before electrical stimulation, a group of test subjects in their 60s and 70s performed significantly worse on a visual working memory task than subjects in their 20s. After 25 minutes of electrical stimulation delivered via Star Trek-like headset, the older adults caught up to the younger group. Both ages performed the same on the task. Their brains were basically zapped back in time. There was also a group of participants in the younger group who performed worse than their fellow young peers on the exercise. But after the same amount of electrical stimulation, their performance on the task had also improved. So, you know, there's hope. Plus, the improvements in cognitive performance for the older group lasted for at least 50 minutes, which was the duration of the experiment. So who knows, maybe the effects lasted even longer. People may balk when they hear about electrical stimulation of the brain. It may call to mind electroshock therapy, a rather blunt instrument used in the early parts of the 20th century on patients with psychosis or schizophrenia, often against their will and without much demonstrable therapeutic effect. But while those early cases may be infamous in the world of medical ethics, there are now plenty more examples of safe and effective electrical stimulation of the brain. Doctors are now using transcranial alternating current stimulation, the same technology used in this memory study, or transcranial direct current stimulation to test treatments for things like severe depression or to enhance concentration. So while relatively safe in the context of a controlled research environment, the hype around the possibility of electrical stimulation devices has led to a trend of consumer electronics, brain-stimulating ones, or even DIY brain stimulation kits. which it doesn't take a genius to guess, is not a good idea. Do not try this at home, because if you do, you risk seriously messing up your head with mood changes or even inducing seizures. This study and many others like it, working on what we call the entrainment of brainwaves, is just the very beginning of understanding where and how memory function breaks down and what the long-term solutions might be. The neuroscience community is just dipping its toes into how we could put this into play as a real-world treatment for the aging brain, preserving your memories and hopefully your quality of life for as long as you live. You've probably seen our new show, Sick. It's all about what's happening in your body when things start to go wrong. We're talking Lyme disease, measles, lupus, and more. Is there a disease or illness you want us to cover? Let us know down in the comments and make sure you subscribe to get all your science news. Thanks for watching.